Then number of firms, the number of firms under perfect competition is so large that no individual firm by withdrawing from market can cause any significant change in the total market supply. Okay. Loss, if lower price is fixed. See, if for example, I just want to, like everyone is selling the pen for 10 rupees. I want to sell it for 20 rupees. So I'll face the loss. Plus, if I want that, I will keep the price for 5 rupees. Then everyone will purchase from me, but I will face the loss. Right? That's why the firm is not the price maker. It is a price taker. Who is the price maker? Industries are the price maker and they determine that this is the price and you have to work accordingly. Okay? First you will write this, then the next one. Clear? No? Yes?
Yes, well.
Okay.
Good morning, teacher. Good afternoon, teacher.
Good afternoon. How are you, Siona?
Yeah, I'm fine. Thank you.
Okay. So today we are starting with this, right? As we are about to finish the chapter. I hope you are watching the recording, Siona, right?
Which I got the link. I will be watching.
Yeah, you have to watch it because, you know, if you will not watch it, then nothing will be clear to you. Right?
I have to watch from home. January last week onwards. Yes. Because now also we have our practicals. Like day after tomorrow is my economics practicals.
Okay. So you prepared well?
Ma'am, for that it's basically from the project. Like tomorrow I have my accounts and then day after tomorrow economics.
Okay.
So, yeah. It will be from the, for economics teacher will not ask us like the full portion, but then for other subjects like they're asking for the full portion from the full portion.
Okay.
That's right.
Okay, no issue. So once you get free, you can just, you know, continue watching this.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, probably tomorrow.
Yes. And don't miss the Friday class. Okay?
Okay, ma'am.
Friday, I'll take 2 hour classes and over there, okay. We will be doing the correlation part. So
ma'am, what's the correlation? Oh, yeah. Ma'am, what's the time?
12 IST.
Okay, so 1:30 for me.
No.
Ma'am, Friday. Sorry?
We are behind, na? Indian time is behind.
Okay. No.
You are 1.5, you can say, it's forward or behind?
For me, like from here, Indian time is faster.
Yes. So 12 okay. IST, that means I think 10:30 at your place.
10:30,
na?
Yeah. Sorry. homogeneous means same, right?
Yes, homogeneous means same and heterogeneous means different, right? Girls, are you done?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, others, done? Anyone who is still writing? Or you want me to wait?
No, teacher, we are done.
Okay. Now coming to next one, which is effect of free entry and exit. Right. So over here, if at equilibrium price a firm is earning abnormal profit, right? However, with normal profit, there are many new firms will be attracted toward entering the industry, right? And this will shift the market supply to the right, and price will come to down because you have so many companies who are selling the same product, right? Free exit means if the price is low enough such that the firms are incurring losses, right? So at that time, everyone will exit, right? Because if you want to invest somewhere, you will invest where you are getting the profit, not where you are facing the loss. So at that time, they move. This because of the supply reduces. And when supply reduces, prices will go down. Earlier, you have 5 shopkeepers who were selling the chocolate. But now you have only 1 shopkeeper. So of course, they have limited stock, so price will definitely increase. Firm will continue to exit till your AR become equals to your AC. Clear? This is what you have to write. Very, very important. Write quickly, very quickly. Okay, what you will write? You will write effect of entry of free exit and free entry and free exit. So free entry, these are the things. Free exit, these are the things. Okay.
Done, ma'am.
Okay, everyone done?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Okay, now I'm giving you one quite good homework. Okay. This one. Just take the screenshot. Done?
Yes, ma'am. For me, this is not there.
Yes. But I was just telling you why you this is important, right? This is not a part of your syllabus, this one. You don't have to learn this. But this is part of your syllabus, perfect competition, right? But why monopoly, monopolistic and oligopoly? Because in the previous chapter, if you remember, there I was talking about imperfect competition, perfect competition, right? So over there, instead of writing imperfect competition, they will write monopoly. Or they will just write that where, you know, the, where the buyers and the sellers are large in number or, you know, one seller is there, large number. So you should know that, you know, these are the differences between, these are the part of imperfect, these three, and this is perfect. When you will make a table, you have to learn this by heart. There's no doubt in that. But this you should know because we learn something in a very good way when we compare it. Right? So in the previous chapter, when they will give you, instead of writing imperfect competition, they can write, you know, in a monopoly competition, tell us the behavior of AR and MR. They can. Right? This one is important for all. You have to learn this. Clear? So that's why I am asking you to write it down because hardly it will take 5 minutes or 10 minutes to make it, but it will give you a clarity between imperfect competition and perfect competition. Definitely, they will not ask you the difference between this and this, the theoretical part, but at least instead of writing imperfect, they can write any word from this. So you should know. Clear? So, number of